itself lately. CNN made a mistake last week on a story and corrected it. A Washington Post reporter made a mistake in a tweet on Friday, not only took down the tweet, apologized personally to the president. ABC's Brian Ross got a story wrong. His network suspended him. Those are facts, and not easy facts for anyone in this business to swallow. The president, however, seems to believe that these mistakes are something more. CNN's Jim Acosta asked Sarah Sanders about it at today's White House briefing.
I would just say, Sarah, that journalists make honest mistakes, and that doesn't make them fake news. But the question that
I have...
But
when journalists make honest mistakes, they should own up to them. Sometimes, and a lot of times you don't. But there's a difference. There's a very big... I'm sorry, I'm not finished. There's a very big difference between making honest mistakes and purposefully misleading the American people, something that happens regularly. You can't say, I'm not done. You cannot say that it's an honest mistake when you're purposely putting out information that you know to be false, or when you're taking information that hasn't been validated, that hasn't been offered any credibility, and that has been continually denied by a number of people, including people with direct knowledge of an instance. This is something that... I'm speaking about the number of reports that have taken place over the last couple of weeks. I'm simply stating that there should be a certain level of responsibility in that process.
Brian,
I called on Jim.
This is not the line of questioning that I was going down, but can you cite a specific story that you say is intentionally false, that was intentionally put out there to mislead the American people?
Sure. The ABC report by Brian Ross, I think that was pretty misleading to the American people. And I think that it's very telling that that individual had to be suspended because of that reporting. I think that shows that the network took it seriously and recognized that it was a problem.
Sarah, Jim? If I may, though, I was going to ask a question about something
well,
else.
Well, you used it on something else.
Sarah,
Jim?
Sarah, if I may.
Sarah.
Not yet. We're going to keep moving, guys.
If I can ask about the president's accusations.
I'm moving to a different Jim. I'm sorry.
I know, but I didn't get a chance to ask the question that I wanted to ask, which is,
Jim,
can you just say once and for all whether these
Jim, I'm going to say once and for all that I'm moving on to Jim Stinson, and I'm not taking another question from you at this point.
Is it clear to you, Gloria, how Sarah Sanders has any credibility when it comes to lecturing news organizations about facts and honesty? That, I mean, when responsible news outlets make mistakes, like CNN did on Friday, they apologize and they try to correct it as quickly as possible. This White House, I have not heard this White House admitting a mistake at all. In fact, I mean, I remember early on a number of stories, the early briefing by intelligence leaders of the president or the president-elect about the existence of this dossier, the new story which CNN broke, which they were calling fake news and went off on this thing and never admitted,
right.
Oh, actually,